guys, for number 39, we're going to graph the rational function. So there's a couple steps we need to take in order to completely graph the rational function, and that is to find our restricted values to see if there's any vertical asymptotes. We're going to check for horizontal asymptotes, and then we're going to find our x and y intercepts. So first and foremost, let's find our restricted values. So our restricted values are going to be any values of x that don't exist in the equation. In this case, we do have a rational function, which means that in the denominator, we can't have the denominator equal to 0. So we're going to take the entire denominator, x minus 4, and actually set it equal to 0. That way we can figure out what x can't be. And when we solve for x, we get x equals 4. So in this case, x can't be 4, which means that on the graph on the x-axis, at 4, we have a vertical asymptote. Next, we're going to find our horizontal asymptotes. Horizontal asymptotes have to do with the degree of the numerator, let's call that m, and the degree of the denominator, let's call that n. If m is equal to n, then you are going to have a horizontal asymptote at the leading coefficient of the numerator over the leading coefficient of the denominator. And then if m is greater than n, then you are going to have no horizontal asymptote. And then if m is less than n, then you have a horizontal asymptote at y equals 0. So in this case, the numerator's degree is 1, and the denominator's degree is also 1. So m equals n, which means we have a horizontal asymptote at, and the coefficient of the leading term is 2, and the coefficient of the leading term in the denominator is 1. So we have a horizontal asymptote at y equals 2 over 1. So on the y-axis at 2, we're going to draw our horizontal asymptote. So next we're going to find our x and y-intercepts. In order to find our x-intercept, we're going to solve for y being 0. So in this case, y is written out as f of x. So f of x is going to be 0. And then we're still going to have our 2x over x minus 4. And when we solve for x, we're multiplying both sides by x minus 4, which is the denominator. So that's going to still give us 0 equals 2x. And now we're trying to get x by itself, so we're dividing by 2. And that's going to give us x is equal to 0 still. So that tells us that our x-intercept is 0, 0. Now for our y-intercept, we're going to set x equal to 0. So f of x is still going to be f of x. It's actually just going to be f of 0 equal to 2 times 0 over 0 minus 4. And that's going to give us f of 0 is equal to 0 over negative 4, which is just going to be 0, which is the same point that we have here. So our only intercept is actually just 0, 0. You can tell that on the left side of the vertical asymptote, it looks like the graph is going to be doing one of these. But we don't know what's happening on the right-hand side of the vertical asymptote. So let's go ahead and plug in a test point. So let's go ahead and use anything other than 4 on the right-hand side. Let's use a test point x equals 6. So for f of 6, we're going to get 2 times 6 over 6 minus 4, and that's going to give us 12 over 2, which is 6, which means when x is 6, our y is also 6. So that means that our point is going to be right over here, and it looks like our graph is going to be doing one of these. And that is our graph.